Now, in ancient Kemet, it was called Ra-Ka. Ra-Ka. All right? That was the name of it, Ra-Ka. Ra-Ka becomes Reiki. All right? Ra, the sun, light, photonic energy, and Ka, spirit, breath. All right? So, continue on. So, here's the spiritual body, which that you are made up of the Aku, the Ka, the Ba, the Kat, the Ren, the Kabet, and the Ab. Men and gods were supposed to contain the same component parts. So men and gods could have the same parts. Man possessed a physical body, Kat, a soul, Ba, a heart, Ab, a double, Ka, a intelligent, Ku, power, Shekel, a shadow, Kabet, a spiritual body, Sa, a name, Ren, and the gods possess divine counterparts of all these. Alright? Divine counterpart of all these. So we have it even within the esoteric Indian, which is the Vedic text, Sanskrit, you have the Rupa, which is the body or element of form, the prana, the breath of life, the astral body, manas or intelligence, the kama, which is rupa or animal spirit, the buddhi, which is spiritual soul, and the atma, which is pure spirit. All right, the Egyptians had, even is a little bit different than the one that we just had, but they all speak in reference to the same, most of the same body parts, even though there's some little similarities, you know. But here we have the ka, the body, the ba, the soul of the breath, the kaba, the shade, the alku, intelligence or perception, the set, the ancestral soul, the pita, which the word Buddha come from, the first intellectual father, and atmu, now, a divine or eternal soul. So when they talk about Adam, being Adam Kadmon within the Kabbalistic teachings, all right, who heard of Adam Kadmon? All right, that's the in the Kabbalistic teachings, all right, or Judaism. Now, what we find is that Adam, or Atum, or Atmu, is nothing but the eternal soul. But they have us thinking that it was Adam who was formed 6,000 years ago, a European. But it's talking about the eternal soul, as you just seen. Atmu, or Atma, is Adam, which is the eternal soul. In your first form, which is the heavenly man, which is the divine soul itself. And that divine soul took on elements of this physical earth and condensed itself. So the mind condensed itself into physical form. That's what you are, a walking thought form. You are a thought of God in flesh. You are the soul in flesh. Alright? That's what we are. All right? So as you see, the sevenfold nature of man, and here it is, Atma, the divine part, Atma also written as Atman, is the highermost or supreme part of man's spiritual being. It is pure, eternal spirit. It is the higher self. It's the higher self. So in the more science temple teachings are what's called the circle seven, as well as also in the questionnaire 101 of the Moorish teachings, it speaks of